correctly so, is going to do what we're going to allow inside next week, and that is the masks become optional. So let's feel free. We're outdoors, so if you're comfortable without a mask and if you're comfortable wearing one, then please do. Thank you.
I should know. I'm his mother.
You're his mother. Yeah. You should. You've known them for years.
Yeah.
You got your t-shirt on already.
You got your t-shirt on already. Warming up the Kim. I have to do the butterfly song. I'll warmed up in that. Apparently, I have to do action.
I left that to
the action's in there. Apparently,
I will not if I still remember.
Well, yeah.
I can't see what the video is.
All the moms look.
Great. Just call her. Hey, you.
Is it here?
Hey, you.
Yeah, they're predicting there's going to be a big
spread of 25 faces.
Now the school has started, you know?
That's a good. That's all right, that's okay. The temperature will do it for you. Guys doing anything? He's on already.
What happened to Kim?
She's gone.
Oh, I was going to say, he usually gets
gone. Well, good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Right off the top of the service, I would like to acknowledge with deep regret and with deep prayers the passing of Queen Elizabeth.
Yeah.
We give thanks for her life on earth and for the way that she lived her life with poise and with grace and with dignity. Let light perpetual shine upon her. We also ask that, you can't hear me? How about this one?
Yes.
That one's better?
Yes.
Okay, let's try that again. Just off the top of the service, we acknowledge with regret and with deep prayers the passing of Queen Elizabeth. We give thanks for her life on earth and for the way that she lived her life with dignity, with poise, and with grace. We also pray for the royal family as they mourn her passing. We also think now with prayer of King Charles III as he resumes, or as he takes over the throne. I'm going to ask that you remove your hats and allow a moment of silence for the royal family and the coronated. Thank you. So we gather as a community with the singing of a part of the family. Okay, so welcome to St. Saviour's on this outdoor service. The last time we tried one was in June, and it rained, so we went indoors. So this is actually outdoors, so thank you for joining us. Very happy to be here to do this. We've got lots of hamburgers and hot dogs and other goodies to share after, so you'll notice that there's tables outside and some inside. You'll have the option later to do that. We always start with acknowledging any birthdays or anniversaries that we're aware of. I know that Glenn Lillies, who isn't with us today, but he turned 80 yesterday, and he said that he'd be happy if I acknowledged his birthday and told everybody his age, too. He was good with him. Interestingly enough, both Glenn Lillies and myself, this month, I'm not sure the exact date, but we celebrate the 50th anniversary of graduating as chartered accountants. Wow. It's a long time ago. I know I was a young kid when I got it. Is there anybody celebrating a birthday or an anniversary they'd like to tell us about? Yes.
On Tuesday, it was 10 years that I quit smoking.
Whoa!
That's very good. You should have run it 10 years before then. That's very good. No, remain standing. That's worthy. That's
yeah, good. That is.
Yes.
Saturday is the one-year anniversary of my cancer surgery, which was completely successful.
Wow, that's really insane. Fantastic. Yes.
I can't stand up, but it's my son's wedding next Saturday. Paul and Tamara.
Good. We'll keep that in our prayers. Thank you. Is there anybody? Yes, sorry.
September 4th was 2 years from my heart attack.
Oh, wow. Well, really insane. That's lovely. Yes. Is there anybody that joined us for the first time today? Yes, Loyula. Yeah, the young lady in the front. Okay, we're going to offer the blessing.
May the blessing of the Lord be upon you. We bless you in the name of the Lord.
So once we're inside next week, which we're not, but we're going to try, and I think it starts next week, we're going to try to start each service with a children's hymn, with a children's talk, followed by a children's hymn. And so the song we're going to do is what we would normally use a song like that for the children's song. We don't have a children's talk today. I believe we do next week, Kim. Yeah, I think it is Kim doing it too. You're not?
Gary.
Gary's doing it next week. Gary, thank you. And normally they'll talk about the gospel or some special date or something that's going on either in the church or in the better part of your other life. We don't have that today, so I just want to talk a little about the song that we're going to sing. And it's called If I Were a Butterfly. And you can see that if you read carefully in all of the words, you're going to find out that what we already know is that God created all of the creatures, including us as human beings, but all of the creatures that fly and walk and so on, crawl on the earth. But he keeps bringing us back to the chorus where even though from time to time as kids or the kids in us, you know, we muse about what it might be to, you know, walk like an elephant or fly like a bird or whatever. But the line that keeps saying is, I just thank you, Father, for making me me. And so the whole idea there is that we're all creatures, individual in our own right, and yet we're all part of the greater creation. And so as we're singing that song, If I Were a Butterfly, Colleen is going to show you all of the motions, the stuff that you have to do, that flap your wings and all of that sort of stuff. Colleen, come on up, and If I Were a Butterfly.
If I were a butterfly.
Try that again, I didn't hold my feet. I'm trying to figure out how I'm going to get into part of the family with that, too. That wasn't going to work. Okay, let's try that again. Sorry. Save us.
Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Hallelujah.
We sing together now our hymn of praise, This Little Light of Mine.
You need an assistant?
Yeah.
Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
continue in service with Come Let Us Sing, the contemporary version of the Beneath.
Heavens above grow black, for I have spoken. I have purposed. I have not relented, nor will I turn back. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And we continue in song with the Jubilati. For the second reading.
A reading from the letter of Paul to Timothy. I am grateful to Christ Jesus our Lord, who has strengthened me, because he judged me faithful and appointed me to his service. Even though I was formerly a blasphemer, a persecutor, and a man of violence. But I received mercy because I had acted ignorantly in unbelief. And the grace of our Lord overflowed for me with the faith and love that are in Christ Jesus. The saying is sure and worthy of full acceptance, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the foremost. But for that very reason, I receive mercy, so that in me, as the foremost, Jesus Christ might display the utmost patience, making me an example to those who would come to believe in him for eternal life. To the King of the ages, immortal, invisible, the only God, the honor and glory forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And we continue again in worship with Joy is the Flag.
High in the sky of the whole world. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Now all the tax collectors and sinners were coming near to listen to Jesus. And the Pharisees and the scribes were grumbling and saying, "This fellow welcomes sinners and eats with them." So he told them this parable. Which one of you, having 100 sheep and losing one of them, does not leave the 99 in the wilderness and go after the one that is lost until he finds it? And when he found it, he lays it on his shoulder and rejoices. And when he comes home, he calls together his friends and neighbors, saying to them, "Rejoice with me, for I found my sheep that was lost." Just so I tell you, there will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous persons who need no repentance. Or what woman, having 10 silver coins, if she loses one of them, does not light the lamp, sweep the house, and search carefully until she finds it? When she has found it, she calls together her friends and neighbors, saying, "Rejoice with me, for I found the coin that I had lost." Just so I tell you, there is joy in the presence of the angel of God over one sinner who repents. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
And we sing again, "You'll Know We Are Christians by Our Love." Now into a time of offering, and our offering hymn will be "Give Me Oil in My Lamp," one of everybody's all-time outdoor favorites. Thank you.
love in my heart, keep me serene. Give me love in my heart, I pray. Give me love in my heart, keep me serene. Keep me serving to the break of day.
Sit or stand if you choose to, for the prayers of the people.
The diocese has sent out a message asking us to please remember Queen Elizabeth and the royal family in our prayers in the coming days and weeks. Our beloved Queen has served with an unstinting faithfulness to her responsibilities and with steady commitment to her faith in both her words and in her actions. Let us pray. Almighty God, the fountain of all goodness, we humbly beseech thee to bless our most gracious Sovereign Lady, Queen Elizabeth II. May your good and faithful servant rest in peace in your kingdom. Heavenly Father, we also ask that you endue the members of the royal family with your Holy Spirit. Enrich them with your heavenly grace. Prosper them with all happiness, and bring them to your everlasting kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
And on this 14th Sunday after Pentecost, as we stand in God's presence, let us pray to the Lord, saying, Lord, hear our prayer. Father, we pray today for our parish and friends, namely our clerics Edmund and Ted, our lay readers Stan, Diane, Linda, Ian, Campbell, Kim, Eula, and Brian, and our choir director and honorary deacon assistant Michelle. We also pray for everyone on our parish prayer list, and we pray for the members of our congregation and their loved ones. Doreen E., Marion B., Jeanette N., Gary H., Dan B., Blaine M., Ted N., Terry, Aurora, Jason, Billy, Joyce B., Heather and family, Janice and family, Anita, Fran P., Doug W., Bill M., Jason P., David G., Eileen F., Cameron J., Cindy B., Evan K., Eula M., and Juanita T. Members present are also free to add their own personal prayers. Lord,
hear our prayer.
Holy Father, we thank you for the blessings in our lives, for your beautiful creation, for the coming harvest, for our comfortable homes, for our families and friends, for our Saint Savior's family, and for the many other blessings we enjoy. Keep us ever mindful that many people in your world do not enjoy the blessings that we do. At this time, members present are free to offer their own personal thanks. Lord,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, as we prepare to enter the new church year and look forward to the special events that will occur over the coming months, give us energy and commitment to meet the needs of our parish. Help us to discern and keep us ever mindful of our responsibilities as Christians, doing your work and spreading your holy word throughout our community. Lord,
hear our prayer.
Lord, your beautiful creation is inundated with both human disasters of war and violence and natural disasters such as forest fires and floods, both in Canada and around the world. In all such disasters, we pray for the victims killed injured or displaced, and for their loved ones. Be with them and give them strength to get through their crisis. We pray especially for the unjustified conflict in Ukraine and the terrible flooding in Pakistan. We also pray that our military, our police, our firefighters, first responders, and all emergency workers, wherever they may be, are kept safe as they try to help their fellow human beings. Lord,
hear our prayer.
Dear Lord, preserve us with your mighty power and let the Holy Spirit be with us and guide us so that our hearts are pure and we have the strength to resist all the evil things that life presents us with. Heavenly Father, in you we live and move and have our being. Guide and strengthen us by your Spirit, that in all the cares and occupations of our lives we may not forget you, but remember that you are ever and always walking with us. Help us to trust in your love and be confident that we are always safe with you. Lord,
hear our prayer.
Gracious God, you have heard the prayers of your faithful people. You know our needs before we ask and our ignorance in asking. Please grant our requests as may be best for us and keep our hearts and our minds open to hear your answers. This we ask in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
At this time, we'll join together and send the collect found in your leaflet. Almighty God, you call your church to witness that in Christ we are reconciled to you.
Help us to obtain the good news of your love, that all who hear it may turn to you, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Together we say the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
May the Lord bless and keep us. May the Lord make his face to shine on us and be gracious to us. May the Lord look upon us with favor and grant us peace. A few announcements before we move on. This service will be uploaded to YouTube, and acknowledge again, it used to be where Tyler and Kendra or somebody would send the link and tell you that it's on YouTube. That doesn't happen anymore, but it is on YouTube, and all you need to do is go to St. Xavier's Church on YouTube, and you'll find this later today probably, or tomorrow. The auction continues on St. Xavier's Auction. Next week, we'll be back indoors. Sunday school and nursery are expected to start, so we'll get the young ones out here. There'll be a choir practice at 9:30, Michelle. And as we're doing outdoors today, masks will be optional in the parish building starting next week, so you judge yourself accordingly, and that's how we're going to at least try it for now. Our closing hymn is "Oh, When the Saints Go Marching In."
Number when the morning glory comes.
number
when the new world is revealed. Oh, when we gather on the throne, oh, when we gather on the throne, oh, Lord, I want to be in that number when we gather on the throne. Oh, my God, hallelujah day, oh, my God,
a great finish.
Yep.
I forgot to mention that, but everybody knows because they still got their notes from last week. Pick your favorite hymn next week. Okay?
I won't be sick.
And Michelle guarantees she'll be here. If not, bring the words to 100 Christian Soldiers. We'll keep you posted. Just going to offer the grace before we, so that we don't need to do it later. But as I mentioned, chairs here, you can take them over there. You can choose to eat outdoors, but all of the food will be served indoors. It's going to take the crew probably, I don't know, 20 minutes or so, 25 minutes to get the first food off the grill. So that's a time of visitation and take us into the noon hour. Or there's tables set up inside if you choose to eat inside, then feel free to do that. So just bow your heads as we offer the blessing. Heavenly Father, as we begin a time of fellowship and food that follows this service, we ask you to bless our gathering, bless the food we're about to receive, and keep us mindful of those who don't enjoy many of the things that we often take for granted. And we ask that all in your precious name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Our service has ended, but our ministry and mission continue. So let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah.
Enjoy the rest of the day, everyone.
Yes, you too. Yeah. Okay. Are you going to eat outside? Are you going to eat outside?
I'm not. Oops.